long as there is thought in the mind, our mind will never be clear. If our mind is not clear, we cannot see anything clearly. If we can't see clearly, we cannot take good decision. If we cannot take good decision, we can't reach to the good destination. So like in the bottle of water, if there is a dust inside, as long as it is not removed, it cannot be drinkable. And the water will never be clear. So therefore, I think first stage to get wisdom in our mind, first I think we have to clear this, you know, the disturbing emotion, which is called thoughts. Now to remove these thoughts, settle these thoughts, the process of removing these thoughts, settling these thoughts, is called the practice of shamatha. Actually, there are different types of shamatha, but it can be summed up into two: object shamatha and objectless shamatha. Generally, it is considered into two, but according to Vajrayana, again there are three types of shamatha: dharmakaya shamatha, sambhagakaya shamatha, and nimanakaya shamatha. Actually, dharmakaya is our mind, and sambhagakaya is our sound, and the nirmanakaya is our body, if we recognize. If we don't recognize, then it's different thing. Okay. Now, what is nirmanakaya shamatha? Nirmanakaya shamatha is any object that is visible. If you see, everybody can see. I can touch, I can feel, like Buddha's statue, like a flower, anything that is visible. So, if you look at that, if we try to keep our mind focus on that object, so it is called nirmanakaya shamatha. That's very important to know, and there's a reason why it is called nirmanakaya. Now, sambhagakaya shamatha means inside our mind, anything that we can see. This is sambhagakaya. Now, why this is nirmanakaya? What we can see outside is nirmanakaya, and why some kind of dramas, picture or something in our mind is sambhagakaya? Why it is sambhagakaya? Now, reason is, there are so many reasons. One reason, if I give, nirmanakaya form of a Buddha we can see. Like Guru Rinpoche is nirmanakaya form. Like Gautama Buddha, our Buddha is a nirmanakaya form. Tulku Shakchatupa, Tulku Pema Jumne. So Tulku Desha. So these are all nirmanakaya, which we can see, which we can touch, which we can feel. These are nirmanakaya form. That's why our body is nirmanakaya, because we can see. Sambhagakaya manifestation is within our mind. When it happens, only when our delusion is gone. I think first we should try to, you know, reduce or make no delusion. If there's no delusion, we don't have to expect, we can see. But if we do not reduce our delusion, remove our delusion, then there's no sambhagakaya actually. We in the nirmanakaya, we expect something to be seen. No, it is not going to happen. It is really not going to happen. So therefore, it is called as a nirmanakaya. No. I think you have to correct me. Nobody is correcting me. Sambhagakaya. Sambhagakaya shamatha. So that's why. Either closing or not closing eyes, you know, we can imagine something. Anything that you imagine in your mind, nobody knows, no? Nobody will know that. So that is called sambhagakaya. then another one is dharmakaya. Now dharmakaya is neither the outside form nor inner manifestation. Neither both. It is total emptiness, which is neither seen nor felt anything. So that is Dharmakaya. Now why our body is Nirmanakaya? Because we can see, we can touch it. Now sound, we can hear, right? Mm-hmm. But can you see? Can you touch? No. So that's why it's considered as a Sambhagakaya. Then Dharmakaya is our mind. At least sound we can hear. At least our body we can touch it, we can see it. But how about the mind? Neither we can see nor we can hear. Emptiness, right? So that is, so now that taking that emptiness as object of meditation. Now we should take emptiness itself as an object of meditation. Our object, subject is me, meditator, and to meditate that object as emptiness is Dharmakaya Shamatha. Now me as a subject, and who is going to meditate in the mind, like Dharma or anything in the mind. That taking as an object is a Sambhagakaya meditation object. Then anything that, you know, outside, like this, anything, Buddha image, flower, that can be seen, visible. That is Nirmanakaya kind of shamatha practice.